Ken Trahan with Lenny Van Gilder for SportsNola.com and our weekend preview brought to you by First NBC Bank with 30 locations throughout the greater New Orleans area. Well, the New Orleans Saints play their dress rehearsal game against the Houston Texans Saturday night in the Mercedes-Benz Superdome. This is the game that most tells you what you want to know heading into the regular season, where regulars play the most, except for those who are hurt. And Lenny, this team is a mash unit when it comes to linebackers.
Yeah, and unfortunately, you may be facing the best running back in the NFL in Arian Foster on Saturday night. So it's going to be interesting to see what some of these young, less experienced guys do in this situation. You're going to learn a lot about some of these guys and what they may be able to do for you down the road. Obviously, the guys you want out there in most cases, probable exception of Scott Shanley, but other than that, the guys who can primarily play in the middle won't be on the field Saturday night because of injury. We may see some of Barrett Roode in the second half, just getting acclimated to the system after the trade late Monday, and that was obviously in reaction to the number of injuries that the Saints have had at the position.
And, of course, you mentioned Scott Shanley. Lazarus lives. What can I tell you? A lot of people have wanted to bury him many, many times, but it's clear he'll be here, and it's clear he'll be a prominent part of this football team. The other big news of the week with the Saints, Aaron Cromer becoming the interim head coach. Saints fans understand that. And this was no surprise, Lenny. This was widely believed to be the case for quite some time.
Well, the thing it does is it gives you somebody who is clearly on the fast track to becoming a head coach. He interviewed with the Colts last year, would have interviewed with the Rams after the before the 49ers playoff game, but at that point Jeff Fisher had taken the job. So he's a guy that is well-respected around the league as an up-and-comer, and it doesn't disrupt your coordinator positions. Obviously, you could have chosen Pete Carmichael, Steve Spagnuolo, Greg McMahon, one of your three coordinators to possibly step into the spot, but they can keep doing what they do, and Aaron Cromer can then step into the head coaching position.
I think it's a seamless move. I think it's the right move to make, and his history with Sean Payton is deep, dating back to Miami of Ohio. They are very close, and as you mentioned, clearly it allows the coordinators to call their games respectively and focus on their jobs. Of course, you can check out video interviews and a nice piece as of Friday on the American Legion World Series champion Retief Oil team based at Jesuit High School. And tremendous accomplishment. Didn't think we'd see that again in our lifetimes after the Rummel base team won it in 2006, but they did it. What a tremendous accomplishment.
Well, this was a team that really the stars aligned for, with four guys coming back, getting that experience to come back with a team that was already very good without those returning college freshmen coming back to this team. And that's the kind of chemistry you need to make this happen. And what can you say about Emerson Gibbs? How great was he over the last 2 weeks? He walked two guys in 38 innings in his last four starts, plus one relief appearance sandwiched in there. The guy just throws strikes. I mean, the first person that comes to mind, maybe not on just ability, but the ability just to pound the strike zone, is Greg Maddux. Not that you're trying to make that analogy in terms of ability, but just remind you a lot of that he's not going to beat himself with walks.
Well, 35-4, those are the numbers. Think about that record combined between American Legion and prep since he's been at Jesuit, and he deserves all the accolades he gets. He's a remarkable pitcher. The name that they were mentioning over at Jesuit at the assembly this morning was Kenny Forsang, and trying to correlate him to somebody very similar at the time. Bottom line is, you don't have to throw 90 miles an hour to be a really good pitcher, and Emerson Gibbs is clearly evidence of that. It's going to be a fun weekend, Lenny. We look forward to it.
Absolutely, and also one other thing we should probably mention, we do have coverage as well on the site of UNO's admission, if you will, into the Southland Conference. It'll be a 14-team league by the time the weekend's over, with Abilene Christian coming into the league, and that is a very positive move for UNO in terms of getting themselves back to where they want to be.
Great move, no-brainer, happy to see it, and Godspeed to the Privateers. Lenny, thank you as always.
We'll see you Monday.
Want to thank you as well. Don't forget, SportsNola.com is where you want to be all the time, courtesy of First NBC Bank, where you need to do your banking. Have a great weekend. God bless.